Where are you going?
Here, adequate notice of this meeting has been provided in accordance with the Open Public Meetings Act. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the Pledge of Allegiance and for the National Anthem, both of which will be led by students of Walls Middle School.
Thank you.
as we had our meetings from town to town, we asked them, Governor Bondi, municipalities which were having the meetings, give us the name of a nonprofit or the recognition of a small donation from the Board of Freeholders. This governing body has selected now Cavalry Union Church and accepting is Reverend Ed Muskie. Reverend? A little bit about now Cavalry Union Church, it was founded in 1910, which by the old map means it's 113 years old. 104 years old. That's right, that's the new one. It's been a sanctuary for the residents of Bonneville for over a century. In July of 2013, a torrential storm sent water flowing into the basement of the 100-year-old building, collapsing the foundation and leaving the temporary building. But 3 feet of water, the mud filled the basement, ruined heaters and kitchen appliances. It was a mess, but during the rebuilding process, Borough Runnymede offered the Runnymede Senior Center for Social Services, and after months of rebuilding, Mount Calvary is a historic church and parish right here in Runnymede. It's recently been fully renovated. Members are back in the church, so it's a truly, truly historic occasion to have Mount Calvary back. So, Reverend, congratulations.
Said everything I always said, just about it's a privilege and an honor to have been a part of this community before the community was a community. The Mount Calvary Union Church predates the actual establishment of the borough of Runnymede, and it's been a proud member of this borough, and we are fortunate to be a part of it, and a lot of the community, a lot of members came together in helping us with the reconstruction of the wall. Still a ways to go. A lot of work to do on the inside. We appreciate the support of the council. Appreciate the generosity of many of the members of the community. It's been a privilege, and we look forward to another 5 or 4 years and beyond. Thank you very much.
Thank you. that you are working for the town council certified. So I got a phone call that we had a woman who was very upset, a little nervous about getting certified. And so we came in, and when I first met Kathy, she seemed a little frazzled like I was when I first did it. And it is such a hard process to go through. But by the end of our conversation,
surrogate, Pat Jones. Pat, welcome to the meeting. Joe Ripa. And our very casually dressed Sheriff Chuck Berman. Oh, no, he's a sheriff. Joe Craig.
Thank you. Good evening, everyone. You know, during the Christmas holiday, a lot of times I hear a lot of great stories. We hear about people giving of their time, giving of themselves. Last Christmas, the county was very pleased when the 911 communication center staff stepped into the community and actually helped a family that had been robbed of all of their Christmas gifts and was able to give their kids a really great Christmas along with other border municipalities. During the holidays this year, or last year actually, we actually had one of our own step up and do something good, not just for a community member, but one of his own colleagues. I want to ask PST coach King Dillon to come up and join me and his wife. Please. On December 19th, PST Dillon observed a fellow PST colleague in distress after eating. After trying to clear his airway with food, water, noticing that his colleague was becoming physically distressed. PST Diller asked if he was okay. His colleague was unable to answer, and he performed the Heimlich and basically saved his colleague's life. So not only is this gentleman trained to actually deal with individuals and families in those stressful situations and talk to them and calmly deal with them so they can make the right decisions, he actually did it in the office under distress themselves, and tonight we wanted to present you with a proclamation to tell you how grateful we are for your dedication and hard work, not
citizens of Camden County, but to your fellow colleagues. Thank you. Spells out in detail more about what PXT Mueller did on December 19, 2013. And again, on behalf of the entire Freehold Board, I know that your director is here, that your directors are here and asking to come up as well. Bob Laker, Chief Mankowski, sharing this moment. I know they could probably share a couple of brief things. I'll ask one of them just to say a couple of nice things about you. Then we won't give you the opportunity to see that. That's okay.
Congratulations, thank you.
Pat has been instrumental in the following areas of improvement.
first one is certainly something that I know Linda and Freeboarders certainly feel has been something that's been a success so far. And that's the opening of two new branches in Kansas City, which a lot of times people don't recognize. When you're opening a library, that doesn't happen too often on your county. Usually you're either losing them or you're trying to sustain them once they're back. Pat has also brought new resources for technology, such as downloadable music, magazines, ebooks, streaming music, and movies have become available in library pages. As I've said many, many times, libraries continually change. This is one of the biggest changes that you'll see with libraries throughout the country. In addition, Pat has come up with, along with Linda and the other commissioners, an innovative teen space at the Wilson Branch, which has been a success. Increased programming for children, teens, and adults. The growth of the library circulation, program attendance, and computer use, and the number of cardboards, which you don't often see. You often see cardboards actually increase throughout this year. So on behalf of myself and the entire community board, thank you very much, Pat, for all you've done for us.
Notice about Pat, but he also collects old 45 records and antique cards, which he proudly displays in the front of his house.
I'm
And I have Earl White. Congratulations, sir. So tonight we have the honor of recognizing Lieutenant Colonel Robert E. Jennings for all his hard work to the Civil Air Patrol. For those of you who don't know the Civil Air Patrol, every community, or a lot of communities, every community, has a group that's called the Civil Air Patrol. A lot of volunteers who are usually former service members or who are still recurring points to their reserves work with young men and women on the Civil Air Patrol with different types of skill sets, whether it be using mapping functions or office emergency management skills, just teaching young men and women about how to survive and also be dedicated to community service. And tonight, Lieutenant Colonel Robert Jennings has served as the commander of the local unit of the Civil Air Patrol, Jack Swiper Composites Club from Cherry Hill for over 3 years. I think that deserves a round of applause. He's also served as a Civil Air Patrol Incident Commander for New Jersey. He has directed more than 7,000 man-hours for response throughout the state, providing volunteer manning of Red Cross and County OEM shelters, and aerial damage assessment, photography for your manpower response coordination. He's been a volunteer with the unit for more than 10 years. Congratulations. Lieutenant Colonel Jennings has had a vital role in the Civil Air Patrol Cadet Program. Under his leadership, the Civil Air Patrol's active volunteer membership in the county has nearly doubled, which that's unheard of, to be honest with you. Because I can tell you from talking to others from around the state and when I was in the reserves, it's very hard a lot of times for people active in the Civil Air Patrol. It used to be very, very vibrant. It's not so much anymore. Under his leadership, the Civil Air Patrol's active volunteer membership in the county, as I said, has doubled. Morale has increased, and more than 200 youth in our county have received valuable training in leadership, technology, and career development. Lieutenant Colonel Jennings has incited Civil Air Patrol members throughout the county to volunteer more than 1,500 man hours of response to hurricanes. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Thank you, Lieutenant Governor.
Next up, Jennifer Bassett. So tonight, we get to honor Jennifer Bassett for the Presidential Award for Excellence in Mathematics and Science Teaching. I put that in a round of applause. Jennifer, as I said, is being honored with the Presidential Award for Excellence in Mathematics and Science. But that wasn't always the case for Jennifer. So Jennifer, as a child, had a problem with math. So ironically, it shows you no matter what happens in life, you can have trouble with a child, you can still overcome things. As you know, math is not something that's easy to overcome. Somebody did attest to that. Now 35 years old young, she credits her mastery of the subject to her elementary school teacher, Peg Lehman, who motivated her to excel in the subject. Jennifer has taught the Berlin School District for the past 9 years. She began substituting there and shortly after was hired as a third grade teacher. Jennifer was recognized by her school district superintendent when he noticed that her ability to use technology and various other techniques to effectively engage students in math and science. In 2012, Anthony Trombone, the district superintendent, nominated Jennifer for the Presidential Award in Excellence in Mathematics for kindergarten through sixth grade teachers. She became the New Jersey finalist in June of 2012. And on December 20th, 2013, President Barack Obama announced 102 teachers elected nationwide, and Jennifer was one of them. She did a trip to Washington, D.C., and $10,000 from the National Science Foundation, which Jennifer said she's going to give to us to help the county. Kids are getting the swing sense. Sorry. So with that, congratulations. On behalf of myself and the entire group, we really want to thank you. Nice to see you.
Thank you very much. Dedicated employee ladder, becoming a laborer, and then an equipment operator. He is now a heavy equipment operator. And if you've ever seen or know or have been a heavy equipment operator, you know that is an incredibly tough job. He's a dedicated employee. He graduated from Camden County Vocational School in Cicloville. His mother, Pat Byrne, as some of us may know, his mother, Pat, worked for Camden County College for 35 years and had done a great job, had a great reputation in our community, so Camden County is in his blood. It also says that Andrew is single. I remember his name.
Yes.
Abstain. Resolutions 9 through 13. So moved.
Leonard?
Yes.
McCray?
Yes.
Nash?
Yes.
Rodriguez?
Yes.
McDonald?
Yes.
Director Pennell?
Yes, resolution 14.
Second.
Three holders, Gantek, Leonard?
Yes.
McCray?
Yes.
Nash? Rodriguez? McDonald?
Yes.
Director Pennell?
Abstained, resolutions 15 through 20.
So move.
Second.
Three holders, Gantek, Leonard?
Yes.
McCray?
Yes.
Nash?
Yes.
Rodriguez? McDonald?
Yes.
Director Pennell?
Yes, resolution 21.
Second.
Three holders, Gantek, Leonard?
Yes.
McCray?
Yes.
Nash?
Yes.
Rodriguez? McDonald?
Yes.
Director Pennell?
Abstained, resolutions 22 through 28.
So move.
Three holders, Gantek, Leonard?
Yes.
McCray?
Yes.
Nash?
Yes.
Rodriguez? McDonald?
Yes.
Director Pennell?
Yes, resolution 29.
Three holders, Gantek, Leonard?
Yes.
McCray?
Abstained.
Nash?
Yes.
Rodriguez?
Yes.
McDonald?
Yes.
Director Pennell?
Yes, resolution 30 through 34.
So move.
Three holders, Gantek, Leonard?
Yes.
McCray?
Yes.
Nash?
Yes.
Rodriguez?
Yes.
McDonald?
Yes.
Director Pennell?
Yes, resolution 35.
So move.
Three holders, Gantek, Leonard?
Yes.
McCray?
Yes.
Nash? Rodriguez?
Yes.
McDonald?
Yes.
Director Pennell?
Abstained, resolutions 36 through 45.
So move.
Three holders, Gantek, Leonard?
Yes.
McCray?
Yes.
Nash?
Yes.
Rodriguez?
Yes.
McDonald?
Yes.
Director Pennell?
Yes, resolution 46. Hearing no motion, the resolution does not pass. At this time, ladies and gentlemen, the meeting is open. Any member of the public who wishes to address the board? I believe we do have a question from Mary Ann Shea of Haddonfield. Hello, Ms. Shea.
I'm Mary Ann Shea, 651 Maple Avenue, Haddonfield. I'm also a member of the Haddonfield Neighborhood Association. I would thank you very much for the opportunity to speak to the media. We're hoping to see you, and I wish to ask you to remove the island and the natural beauty, especially those from Post Mill Road to South Lakeford Drive of the rest of the project. Because what has happened in the past, in the last few years, a few months of concern, they were creating more problems than we were saying they were to solve, namely, traffic problems. Speeding is not the number one problem on Post Street. There are continuing jams at the Kingside Road intersection. There's the difficult intersection of Post Mill Road and Grove Street. And volume, sheer volume, is a difficult problem. Because of the racetrack, shopping center, trailer mall, etc. Speeding, you may know, traffic tickets after many years, one down. Last year, the in 2013, speeding tickets were 50. This year, they were 31. Accidents remain steady about another 20. The project has a many advantages. Among them is the impetus from new people, from the freeholders, to for the road part of the project. Because of that, gave impetus to our commissioners to institute the repair and replacement of waters and sewers along Grove Street. Certainly, the project makes safer Grove Street by the improvement of the curbs and sidewalk. What are the problems? The first, the main problem is that it's, to begin with, it's a poor plan. And it's worsened by attempts to improve. It appears to replicate many of the not-so-great aspects of the recent Ellis Street reconfiguration. This is perplexing highway, mental medium, narrow roadway, brick concrete plantings, and that dicey turn onto Hyde. As you gaze into the eyes of an oncoming driver as you need to make your own turn. It's popular with Patterson residents because it decreases the traffic on Hyde, but it's not too popular with the neighborhood of Battle Street because of their increased traffic. And mainly, this project, the road part, the islands, etc., do not reflect the historic character of our town, which we eagerly and actively promote. The plan to control speeding did so only from Holesville Road to South Bedford Drive. So therefore, speeding was not going to be controlled in this plan, but was not from Holesville all the way out to King's Highway. Bike lanes are now proposed to fix this road. The bike lanes are only proposed from Lake to South Bedford Drive, which creates another problem for cyclists because of the islands. Cyclists, however, might feel that something is better than another, but it doesn't advance the feeling that I hadn't feel of being a bike-friendly community. To the residential streets such as Cedar, Firewood, Edge Park, Beechwood, and Maple. And some of these versions will become popular when people find out the downtown work that you can take Cedar around Road to the community. Yourself. The plans do not ease the movement of plows, police and fire, and vehicles, and trash trucks, and others. Mr. Moscatelli reported that both fire and police chiefs are, quote, uncomfortable with the plan. This certainly is damning within bridge. As a public official, I'm sure you're aware that the project will have a very serious and long-term effect on the lives of law-abiding citizens and drivers. Grove Street should not be allowed to become impediment nor an obstacle to these people. Thank you very much for allowing me to say goodbye.
Thank you. Phil Leonard is our liaison to person. Are you aware of these issues, Phil Leonard?
I was aware of the island, but not the other issue. I was aware of the island issue because I had a lot of phone calls regarding the island. I believe the town has met with the Department of Public Works, Director Martello, our county engineer, Jeff Besson. The island's been taken out. It's all going to be like this.
Why don't we have a conversation with
them? Yeah, I'll have
a conversation. Sam, have a talk. Thank you, Ms. Shea, for coming up. All you had to do was ask to shake, that's all.
Seeing no one further, move to close. So
moved. All those in favor? Opposed? The public hearing is closed. At this time, ladies and gentlemen, I will open the floor to members of the Board of Freeholders for their comments. We begin with Freeholder Nash.
Thank you, Director. I want to thank the Mayor, Sis, and Council for hosting us. It's always great to be in Runnymede. I want to wish everybody a very happy and healthy New Year.
Thank you, Phil.
Thank you, Director. I want to thank Mayor and Council for hosting us here tonight. It's a pleasure to be here in Runnymede. I also want to thank the employees of the Department of Public Works, Parks, CCMUA, CCFA, and all our employees of Public Safety for all their hard work during the recent salute to the nation. As you know, they work long, hard hours, do a great job for us. A lot of people are embedded in the hall, and they all make sure the roads are safe and clear. I also want to congratulate you, Director, and Deputy Director McDonald, on your recent nomination again as Director and Deputy Director. Have a good night.
Thank you, Phil Rodriguez.
Congratulations, and also thanks to the Department of Public safety, as they can tell you, a lot of very bad today. We announced a very school security protocol language. It's really going to be beneficial across this county to all the sets to be allowed for other counties. Really, the annual information to school employees, public safety officials, families, in case of events, as tax rules. So just wanted to give a real quick congratulations to that department. Rob, all of his staff.
Thank you, Deputy Director McDonald.
Thank you, Director Sis. Thanks very much for having us tonight, members of council. We're looking forward to our great news sign at the entrance to Runnymede. We'll be working on that. Hope to have that up very soon. And I want to join everyone in congratulating all the people, all the guys and women who worked to remove the snow and to melt the ice during our recent storm, the folks of the Sioux Center Way, from buildings and ops and the parks, and of course, our own public works department. And of course, yes, please. And of course, a big congratulations to Mr. and Mrs. Nash.
I'd like to thank Mayor and Council for the kisses tonight. The Hershey kisses. Thanks for having us tonight. It's always great to come to Runnymede. Congratulations to Jeff and Krista, what I think was a great wedding. Awesome. And I just want to thank the employees of Camden County who did a great job day and day on behalf of our residents. With that, I'll take a motion to adjourn. All those in favor? Good night, everybody.